Why do so many enlightened masters take birth in India when the entire world needs them? India is the land prepared for enlightenment. This whole country stood for mukti. This civilization is standing for mukti. That is why I have little love for this country. Otherwise, not as a country. See, I don't have love to this country geographically, as consciously. This country, this civilization has stood for enlightenment. And this is the only civilization which can continue to produce enlightened beings. Can you imagine 17-year-old boy from 17 to 25 of his age did not do any work, did not study, and he is given food, clothes, shelter with respect. In which country it will happen except in India? My life, 17 to 25, the cream of the life is youth. I neither studied nor did any job in that age. If I was in USA and I say I will not work and I will not study, either I would have been put in the shelter or in the road. I would have been homeless or I will be put in the shelter, given all psychological treatment. Now really, understand how I would have been treated. They will think this guy is gone crazy and he is not. I wouldn't have been accepted. So much of psychological torture I would have gone through. Even if I was given a food, shelter, clothes, it wouldn't have come with respect. See this country, 17-year-old man, and he says, I will not work for the society, and I will not study to work for the society. Studying is also what? A promise. I will study now and then contribute to the society. And nobody bothered, and nobody disrespected me. I was given food, shelter, clothes, everything with respect. Which country will do this job? And not only me, thousands like me. I want you to understand one important truth. India has, see, the full-time dedicated priests, monks, nuns. The Hinduism has 3 times more than Christianity. But Christianity population is more than 60%. See, the population-wise, they are 3 times more. But the full-time dedicated priests, monks and nuns, India has 3 times more. The Hinduism has 3 times more priests, monks and nuns than Christianity. Then understand the amount of people dedicated their life to Hindu tradition, the spirituality. In the many Western countries, the people who have become monks and nuns are considered like parasites. But here, they are treated, they are taken care. Because this whole country stands for spiritual realization, mukti, enlightenment. This whole civilization stands for that one truth. Go to Indian villages, you will see. I will take you to my native place. You will be shocked. The small, small villages where their houses will be out of thatched hut and ordinary tiles, but the temple will be stone. Still, there are many cities in India where they will not build bigger buildings than the temple. In my city and Madurai and Palani, in so many places, it is banned as a rule. You cannot build a bigger building than a temple. You cannot raise your house taller than the temple. Still, it is there. So understand, this whole civilization stood for that one truth, enlightenment. That is why this is very conducive for these enlightened beings to land. I always tell people like, when the premature birth happens, you put the baby in the incubator to take care of the baby. The baby needs some care for it to become matured and survive. Same way for an enlightened being to land in the planet Earth and again realize that he is enlightened and to stand up. At that time, that till the 10, 20 years, he needs a kind of a care. He needs a kind of a support. Like a spiritual incubator. He needs a spiritual incubator. India is a spiritual incubator. That is why continuously souls are landing here. Souls are landing here. This civilization stood for enlightenment. This whole civilization stood for mukti. And you will be surprised if you see this around this village. These guys will be in poverty. But first harvestment, anything they harvest, any grain or anything, first share they will bring it to this banyan tree or to our temple. Sometime I tell them, do offering and give it back to them. But they won't take it back. They will feel hurt. No. First share goes to him. First share goes to the divine. See, the whole country is trained for thousands of years. We stood for this one idea. The enlightenment, mukti. Whether wealth or everything. Everything comes next. First comes the enlightenment. I have seen even in the traveling all over the world. Even in sharing, nothing like Indian villages. I am telling you honestly. If they have 1 rupee, they will give 80 paise. Only for that day expense, they will keep 20 paise. But it's not like, when I travel all over the world, not in the developed countries. The developed countries, if they have $1 million, they will think 10 times to write $2-3. Give a $2-3. Oh, what will happen to my, if when the recession happens, what will happen? And that's why recession happens. What to do? Somebody asked, what if the recession happens in India? India will not suffer at all because Indian economy is equally supported by number two. Understand, the whole country may be suffering in the recession, but nothing will happen in practical life. I don't think you understand what I am saying. Because India's economy is not an accounted economy. The number two is two times more than number one. So no recession can give any disturbance to India. You see, so much of a recession is happening in India also. Do you see in practical life anywhere any problem? But if you are in the West, you will directly feel the recession. In India, you will never feel recession. If you are in India for a long time, you know what I am talking. How many are from India, not the West, people who are in USA, I am telling India. Do you have any suffering in? There is no recession. Is there any direct impact of recession on your life? No. But as the people who are in West, there is a direct impact on their life. It's a totally weird country. This country is the greatest miracle of God. Still this country is functioning. You don't know. I'm enjoying this country every day. Anything I see, especially after I started traveling, I understand the value of this country. It's a big mess and beautifully going. And you should go and see in Tirupati how people pour. How people pour. There is something called Neludopadi. Am I right? That pronunciation? Pronunciation is right. Neludopadi. They will wear all the jewels from head to toe and put everything into the undi. Into the undi. So just one moment, they unclutch, they detach. They would have worked years to make that. Means years of hard work. They know. Offer it. Surrender it. It will be villages. If you go and see, it will be villages. Don't think all rich people coming and pouring. Rich people also pour, that is different. From villages. This whole country stood for that one idea. See, just like how people go and pour in Las Vegas. No, that is totally different attitude. This is totally different attitude. That money goes for antisocial elements. And it doesn't directly comes back to society. But when you go and pour it in Tirupati, it directly comes back to society. It directly comes back to society. And see the concept for which they are pouring. Concept for which they are pouring the wealth. Percentage of the population and the wealth held by the population, Hindus are I think third or fourth, but the richest spiritual organization belongs to the Hindus, because the depth and largest crowd gathers in the humanity is KumbaMela. People walk 2000, 3000 kilometers and go to KumbaMela. Every once in 3 years it happens. Next year it is going to happen. Last KumbaMela we attended. I'll tell these guys to show a video of that to you guys. You can see the video. 91 million people gathered. 91 million people gathered. That's the world's largest gathering in the humanity. Recorded history of the humanity. This is the largest gathering. And I want you to know one more thing. Not a single penny is spent in public. See, when this Pope died in Vatican, these guys have started claiming, this is the largest gathering gathered for spirituality. I said, what? God? What is going on? It's only 2 million. It's only 2 million. And the amount of publicity happened, the amount of infrastructure they have, here 91 million. And not only that, not a single penny is spent in publicity. Only one word in that spiritual calendar, it is that today is Masi Mag. That's all. The whole crowd gathers. I want you to know another one important fact. That city where 91 million people gathered doesn't have airport. Allahabad doesn't have airport. Only army airport is there. There is no civilian airport. There is no civilian service. Only train. By walk and train and road. That's all. Another one important fact. This will be very shocking. 91 million people gather. Not a single restaurant where food will be sold. All the 91 million people were given free food as a service. You will not see a single restaurant selling food. Selling food is sin in KumbaMela. So there will be 100,000, more than 100,000 spiritual organizations. They will have their tent. They will have their tent and serve food. Understand, this whole civilization stands for mukti, stands for liberation, stands for the other world, stands for enlightenment. That is why continuously the avatara purushas are landing on this earth. Landing on this. Please don't think I am fanatic about this country. I am not fanatic about this country. I am just stating some facts. What is happening? I am not fanatic because I travel all over the world and see the world. I am just standing. I am just stating the fact or the truth for which this country is standing. Why don't they distribute themselves across countries? Now, I am not saying there are no enlightened masters outside India. There are many. I am saying India is the many, you see, for landing and expressing, this is the best land. Then we start going around. That's all. Otherwise, if they would have put me in asylum, what would have happened? Just tell me. And especially in the young age, you don't know how difficult child I was. You should ask. My mother is here. One day I'll tell her to come here. Maybe she will sit with you guys for half an hour. But one problem, she may not speak fluent English, but somebody can translate. She used to tell. See, the in Indian villages, the teakwood cart will be there. Teakwood cart means it will be at least 1 ton weight, 1,000 kg weight. My power was such, at the age of 3 or 4, I will just tumble the whole cart. And then imagine, just 3-4 year old boy, I'll just tumble the whole, turn the whole cart. And the person was sleeping. Along with the person, don't think. Yes, bare hand. Just I'll tumble the cart. And if I was in USA, what will they do? No, they will put me in some, they will say the hyperactive child and they would have put some medicine. They would have given some medicine and made me dull. What do you call now? You call Indigo kids. If I was in West, they would have diagnosed me as an Indigo kid. What would have happened to my enlightenment? Oh God. I was saved. And it's not one thing. Night, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, I'll come back because I'll be sitting with some sadhus and meditating with something, doing some work. They will not even question me. That's an amazing thing. My parents, they never questioned me. They never, see, it's not that if they question, I'll change myself. But at least they could have tortured me psychologically. I never had a psychological torture from them. Whether my before enlightenment or after enlightenment, I never had, they never interfered with, in my life. I don't think this can happen. Forget about in the West, it will not happen. Even in India, the developed cities, it won't happen. Because it was in village, I had this fortune. So this whole civilization, especially when I left the house, I was, I think, 17 and a half. And I decided to leave the house to do my yatra and take sannyas and for my mission. I went and told my mother, I am leaving. She started crying. I asked her, "You, what do you mean by crying? You are saying that I should not go?" She said, "No, no, no, I cannot stop you. But only thing I felt, I am not able to digest it. I am not able to digest, I am crying, but I cannot stop you. She was very clear. She was very clear. And she said, I can't stop you, but I am not able to digest. So I am crying. It is up to me. I will digest. I will settle down. You carry on your journey. This won't happen in a, even in the cities it won't happen. People are too possessive about it. Too possessive. And it's not that when your son is around you, you take care of them. Just to fight, you need him around. Now this whole civilization stands for that idea. And you see, any village I go with this cloth, food is there. It means the whole, understand, 9 years I wandered from length and breadth of India, did not carry my food or money, anything. Wherever I go, I was given food, shelter, cloth with respect. It means what? This whole country knows a sannyasi should be respected. He should be supported. This is the backbone of this country. You understand? Even in one village, I didn't have suffering. So the whole country knows. That is why I am saying, the civilization stands for mukti. Especially in the train and all. No ticket. No, where is the money? Where is the question of ticket? And this ticket checking, the officers, when they come, they will ask, Baba, Kanaka Chen, did you eat? They will give you food. They will not ask about ticket. They will give you food. Once, some guy was different religion. That guy was a TT. He came. He asked me, Baba, where is ticket? I said, what? Brahma Rajya. Train Brahma, A Brahma, Ami Brahma, Sab Brahma, Ki Brahma. Brahma Rajya, Ki ticket. You are God, train is God, I am God, everything is God. Why ticket? And that fellow said, thank you God and went away. If he is a Hindu, he will not even ask. Somehow he asked and he understood. What they will do? What they can do? They can put me in the railway station. How many days? They have to give food. So better let him go. This whole civilization stands with that. See, I understand. It is because of the sadhus continuously moving all over the country, this country is united. Otherwise, it would have been gone to pieces long before. It would have been to pieces long before. It is the spiritual strength which keep this country unique. Otherwise, different language, different food. See, if I travel from here to USA, I don't have a cultural shock. But if I travel from one state to other state in India, I have a cultural shock. That's the truth. Independent worlds, but still they are together just because of the spiritual bone. This whole country is the spiritual incubator. I always bless this country. Let it remain as a spiritual incubator.